Good morning. It's Wednesday, the 20th of July. Behind me there, that is Barking Station, the eastern end of the Goblin, the Gospel Oak to Barking line, except that 2 days ago, on Monday, it actually was extended by one stop down to Barking Riverside. However, we've had a little bit of hot weather in the UK the last 2 days. TfL actually put out a press release themselves saying do not travel on Monday or Tuesday, so come on Wednesday here to take the train, one stop, and go and ride and see the new station at Barking Riverside. On the station concourse, can you see it there? It says the next Barking Riverside train, the 8:42, leaves from platform 7, because what they've done with the new service is that trains used to terminate at platform 1, and they've now rebooted them, and they terminate, sorry, and they go through at platforms 7, 8 instead. Do you remember the time when District Line trains used to open their doors on both sides here? They don't do that anymore, which makes me sad. This is the old London Overground terminating platform. For some reason it says 12B. I thought it was 1. It says, please listen for announcements. No overground trains are now running in on this platform. They're over on 7 and 8 instead. Gospel Oak on 8. Barking Riverside on 7. And there's a timetable poster up already, but we'll discuss times when we get... And it hasn't actually changed from what it was before, but there's a timetable poster at Barking Riverside as well. We'll also discuss the fact when we get there that C2C trains, C2C, use platforms 7 and 8 as well. So it's the same platform interchange for some, not all, C2C trains, which is handy. Most people got off, but there's a couple on. More importantly, what I want to do is I've got my stopwatch because the timetable says it takes 7 minutes. I don't think it takes 7 minutes, I think it takes about 4 or 5. I'm going to time it and see how long it takes. But while I do that, let's start the stopwatch first. So leaving eastbound from platform 7. Stopwatch running. Here's the diagram and like the map overview to show you and explain where Barking Riverside is. The new 2.5 mile section of track has been built to the east of the existing Barking station. It takes a sharp curve on a new viaduct over the existing C2C lines and heads south towards the river and the location of the new Barking Riverside development. And the carriage map, the line diagram, very much has been updated. Good to see. So that's us going over the curve right now. Is it a bridge or is it a viaduct? The curve piece of track, it's very impressive. And that then leads you down. And I can see it already in the distance, the station coming up. Right, hello, welcome to London's newest station, Britain's newest station. Oh, I should do a station count. Blowing bin bags in the breeze, it's really windy. Loving it already. Welcome to Barking Riverside. That took 5.5 minutes, 5 minutes, 35 seconds, but they do allow 7 minutes in the timetable. We're at Barking Riverside. So I'm on a bench, it's quite windy. There's this incredible, where the sun is shining through, this blue and orange overground roundel is lighting up in this waiting area. The train's just leaving in a second. Where we're actually at is that there's a, on the platform, it's an island platform, platform 1, platform 2, either side. There are two trains stabled overnight for the first services, which were at 5:53. Down that end, there's like a glass waiting area and like an emergency escape route. And if you look out to the side, you'll see that basically this new station has been built in an area of development. What is being developed here? Handily, someone from the Barking Riverside Limited Company is coming along shortly, and we'll have a little chat about that. But just to get you some stats and some numbers for the nerds up to date, if you know your overground history, then you'll know this. If you don't, just to clarify, the Overground, of course, first opened in 2007, and there were 57 stations. When the East London line was eventually finished, that was added in 2010. That took the total to 78 stations. The Surrey Quays to Clapham extension happened in 2012. That took the Overground to 83 stations, and then it expanded. The last time it expanded was in 2015, with the lines taken over from Greater Anglia out from Liverpool Street, and that took it to 112 stations. That includes Battersea Park, by the way. So today, or 2 days ago, Monday as it was, there is now one more station on the London Overground network, taking it to 113 stations in total. By the way, this does also mean for the people that like to do the challenge of trying to get around all the Overground stations in the fastest time possible, that unofficial record, link on the screen below now, has just been reset. You've got to do them all over again. So the entrance exit is down this way. You've got platform 2 that side, platform 1 this side, the stairs here. It's just that at the back here there's not one, but there's two. Two lifts.
Doors closing. Doors closing. Ground floor.
And for those who like to know these things, there's 13 sets. Steps, broken up into 4 sections. There's 52 steps in total.
Thank you.
Timetable with the service is exactly the same as it was before. It's 4 trains an hour every 50 minutes, including Sundays, from 5 in the morning till almost midnight in the evening. That's great. I'm just looking at the line diagram here and I can't but help think, is it Wanstead Park? It's a short 5 minute, less than 5 minute, I think, connection to Forest Gate on Cross Eliz Purp. Black Horse Road has got the Victoria connector. You could argue that Walthamstow Queens Road should maybe also have a Victoria Line connector there, but you can connect. In fact, that makes me think, what is the fastest way into central London from Barking Riverside? Because what you can do, say if you're going to Zone 1, Oxford Circus, you get the Goblin, and by the way, Goblin, because it's Gospel Oak Barking Line, L-I-N, abbreviated for line, but now it's Barking Riverside. Does that now mean it's the G-O-B-R-Lin, the Goblin? Should it be that? Food for thought. Because what you can actually do is that you can change, as I just said, at Wanstead Park, walk to Forest Gate and cross Les Perp and get Crossrail into the heart of town. Or do you change, say, at Black Horse Road onto the Victoria Line, and that whisks you into Zone 1, say if you're going to Oxford Circus. Or how about this? An alternative is, sorry Barking Riverside, is not to use the new station at all, but just to go and get the Thames Clipper from down there, because I looked it up, it is only 7 minutes from the new Barking Riverside Thames Clipper pier down to Woolwich Pier, and from there you can jump onto Crossrail there. Might that be quicker? I sense a beat the tube, race the tube, race to see which way is fastest video may be coming on to see what is the fastest way into Zone 1 from Barking Riverside. Might do that as a video in the future. So there's two entrances, because the gate line is there. There's a side was just a moment ago that takes you out to the western side. There's an entrance exit there that takes you out to the eastern side. But how about this for a bit of fun, people? There's a secret, it's not really a secret, there's a secret door here that takes you into this area, where for some reason there's turnstile gates. I'm not sure why. And it's a bike storage facility. I'm trying to think of any other station in London, and I don't think there is, that's got a separate, huge, capacious, love that word, bike storage facility like this to store your bikes. So I've met the lovely Matt Carpen. How do you do?
Nice to meet you.
You're the managing director of
Barking Riverside.
I didn't really shake your hand.
That's all right.
Just give you a firm handshake.
Welcome. Welcome to the site.
Which means what? What are you responsible for? Why is this station here? What's being built around us?
And this project is it's a regeneration project developing 10,800 homes. And the company that I'm responsible for delivers all the infrastructure, all the funding for things like this, for effectively a new community on the River Thames.
But when the new housing development comes along, will it be 6,000 homes for 6,000 people? But will there be a school or shop or,
so
doctors or what,
yeah,
else, what else will be here?
All of those facilities. So we've got we've already got quite a large secondary school here.
Right.
We've got 3 primary schools, and we've also got a special educational needs school. So the schooling provision again is already here.
Right.
The bits to come are health and leisure centre, commercial spaces. We've got a pop-up cafe on the river at the moment. We've got a new...
There's a cafe there?
Yeah, there's
now?
A cafe. Well, okay. It opens Thursday to Sunday.
Okay.
It's a pop-up kind of bar, cafe. And then we've also got a cafe open at the top of the site, which is called The Wilds.
And that's by the new Uber Boat Clippers pier, which is that opened a couple of months ago, right?
Opened last month.
That's new as well.
Yeah,
so you connect,
brand new.
Connect boats to the overground.
Yeah, so we're probably about, I'd say... It was about a 5-10 minute walk from here to the boat, and then you can connect onto the Uber boats by Thames Clipper service. So that'll take you all the way into central London.
Also, inside the gate line, there's a toilet. Open to all, not staff only, not radar key only. General toilet, open to everyone. Very handy. Also, I just really wanted to lie on the floor for no reason other than that I could, and I like the wide-angled shot. It's very impressive. So there we go, it's station number 2576 on the National Rail Network. I wonder if Brent Cross West will be the new station, the next new National Rail station, and in London as well, coming up later this year, we'll find out. But this, add-in zone 4, connects Barking Riverside through to Barking. Come ride the Overground, come ride its 113th station. Oh, by the way, they're totally giving out tote bags with the goodies inside, so I got myself a nice cup and whatnot. That's nice, came today. Wasn't expecting that. Enjoy the hot weather. I'm getting the train home. Cheers, bye. Thank you.